All right, welcome. Today is Sunday, June 21st, 9 p.m. Eastern, episode 280 of the Sunder. Actually, wait, I said today is Sunday. No, that is incorrect. Today is Tuesday, June 21st, 9 p.m. Eastern, episode 280. See, we moved to Tuesday night here, and I don't know what's going on. This episode is brought to you by some of our ads, Amazon, Noe, Jinx, Busted Tees, and Groupon. Click through the links on our site. It's no cost to you. We steal money from these mega corporations. We take their money, and we harness that into broadband roadways on the internet to give you our ridiculous bullshit. That's what we do. And if you like what you hear, or if you don't, that's fine too. Go by iTunes, drop us a review, rate us. We will read it. We will do that. We'll do all the things. And if you drop us a review on Stitcher, we'll check that out eventually. They're all right. They got bought, so maybe they'll be better. Who knows? What do we got on deck tonight? We got family destruction over bacon. We are going to tell you how to make your own Xbox controller. We're going to fulfill all of Ray's hopes and dreams. We got some Overwatch stuff and so much more. Welcome to the Sundering. Do you remember the best day of your life? No? Well, no, I'm not. Hasu put call in here. I'm not going to read call. I did, didn't I? Damn it.
Wow, that was really... I didn't even get to the show notes yet and I just saw you heard you say that.
God damn it. Well, there you go, Ray. I said it. All right, here, let's start the show.
The Sundering is an explicit podcast which may not be suitable for children, people with delicate sensibilities, animals under 10 pounds, certain towns in Idaho, citizens of Liechtenstein, members of the clergy, fans of the show Cop Rock, and vegans.
The following program is closed captioned for the thinking impaired.
Well, let's start the insanity.
This is the Sundering Podcast with your host, Seraphis.
Self-replicating bacon. I don't like fat chicks cutting my hair because we wouldn't want it to get weird or anything.
Rapist.
He adds to the show and everyone gets upset. This is great.
I know. I know they say this, but I don't care.
And Zia.
Heisler, you're so full of hate. I'm not sure what a podcast is. Slavery is different than a fish.
All right. Well, good evening. I'm Seraphis. I'm joined by my co-host, Ray.
What up? Now with air conditioning.
Woo! Zia, as you can see, is not here yet.
That's normal.
But she is now like moving. She is in the process. I believe she is in North Carolina. So she is getting settled in, so we should hopefully have her back soonish. So that is positive. It's all good things. It's like a circle. Circular. Around the circle. You pay the quarter, you get on around.
Like what, like those swing rides? I always like the swing.
Oh, I was trying to do the thing from Happy Gilmore.
Oh yeah, I haven't seen that movie in a very long time.
Anyway, so it's Tuesday. Ray and I are here.
Tuesday booze day, as I like to say. Yeah.
And I got booze. So I got that. I got some bourbon here. And someone said that Sarah said it. We steal money, and yes, I did say that, and that's, you know, which is funny, because we will steal money from corporations through you clicking through our ad links, but I will not steal from my guild bank.
Oh, I was going to say, you should.
In Phalanx of Nod on Dalaran server, Alliance side, always looking for awesome new people. We've been around for almost 11 years now.
This is my drink.
Is that a baby can?
Yeah.
For babies?
I totally didn't get a chance to go to the store before the show, and there's like nothing to drink in my house except for like tap water and these little baby cans of Diet A&W.
You need to put like a nipple on that and sip that like the baby you are. It looks so tiny in your hands.
It doesn't taste too great either, because I'm not a big fan of diet soda.
It's ridiculous.
But it's made with aged vanilla. So.
Oh, aged vanilla.
I
That's secret. That's secret terminology for cum.
Okay.
Boom.
We have some more, though.
Drink some cummy root beer. You gotta gargle that shit.
I'm surprised I didn't start choking. I can't gargle normally, like, if I do mouthwash or whatever. I just start, like, ah.
All right, so who is hanging out with us right now?
Oh, Jesus. It's been so long since I've done the show.
Oh, my God.
Well, then. We got Hasu. Then we got Adam. Curse at Bot. It's your boy right there. Lemon Turtle. Lycan. Red Sniper 00. Seraphita. And Tully. Tullibardine.
Tullibardine.
Sorry, it took me, like, to do your name in like, sections there, but, yeah.
Tully. The Tullys.
Oh, shit. House Tully.
House Tully.
What up, Blackfish?
Boom!
Yeah.
That's some Game of Thrones knowledge getting thrown down on this show.
Because
boom.
I remember stupid names like that, but I can't
Blackfish.
Remember.
Blackfish should have took the deal. He should have took the deal.
Well.
No spoilers, but I'm just saying he should have took the deal.
You don't even know what that is. He could have been playing blackjack.
You know, all I'm saying is that, like, you remember that show? There was an old game show. It was like, what's behind door number one versus door number two? You have to pick a door. And then they say, like, well, I picked door number one. And then they show them, and they're like, well, you could take what you got, or you could take this other deal instead. What's in the box? Well, he should have taken the deal. Because what was... Yep, should have taken the deal. Anyway... Oh, look, Tully says everyone calls him Tully anyway. So, boom, we could just call him Tully. Hold on, we're saying him. Is it a him or a her? Because if it's a her, then I'm pulling a Zia right now. And I'm going to feel like shit.
I think you're pulling the we can't tell gender by name thing. I don't know what that is.
But. Well, I just kind of assumed because we started going down this Blackfish thing and Tully. And Blackfish is a dude in Game of Thrones, so like I just correlated that. But I could be completely off the mark here. Could be just completely off the mark.
Anyway,
him. It's a him. Boom. Name of a... I'm adding that to my scotch list. Tully Scotch. I'm going to add that. That sounds... I'm always looking for new scotches. Hopefully it's a good one, Tully.
You know why he's always looking for new scotches?
I'm coming for you.
It's because he wants to have an excuse to drink more scotch. But if he drinks the same kind every time, his wife starts getting a little... She's like, come on, why don't you drink something
not,
else?
Not true, because we went to the store, and I was holding a bottle of Breckenridge bourbon, and I was like, oh, but I really also want to get this beer barrel bourbon. And she's like, why not both? And I'm like, all right. So, boom. So, she gave me the okay to go ahead and get two bottles of bourbon. But I'm not drinking that. I'm drinking the Jomi or something thing. I don't even remember what I got. It's some private stock. Whatever. I'm going to finish it up. It's good bourbon. I guess I'm just jumping into what we've been doing. Kickboxing. Lots of motherfucking kickboxing. Fucking punching shit. I'm getting good at the speed bag, right? Getting good at the speed bag.
Well, you get a lot of practice when you punch your own speed bag, you know?
That's right. A lot of sack tapping. Actually, that's what speed bags really look like. They kind of look like someone just dangling a gigantic elephant-sized sack. And you just gotta punch it. So, yeah. So I'm doing a lot of that, and Father's Day, that happened. I got a whole bunch of really cool shirts, and...
Is that one of them?
No, this is just a shirt that I've had for a while. It says, only noobs play Horde. Boom. Oh,
who cares?
Boom. That just happened. Alright. Shots fired! Pew, pew, pew,
pew, pew, pew. How long are we waiting till we can talk about the Warcraft movie?
Oh, what has it been, like, a week? 2 weeks?
I don't know. Finally...
Oh, I saw it! I saw the Warcraft movie!
So did I.
Alright, so spoiler-free, what did you think of it?
First impression of the crowd that we were around, there wasn't one. We went to the 4:15 non-3D showing at... when I was in Calgary, Chili and I did, and we went in there, and there were three people already there, and we were ultra early, and there were three people up way up top, like in the stadium seating, and they had great seats, by the way. I envy big city theaters, because the one we have here, you know, it hasn't changed. I know how long, but wait, we went and saw the first Amazing Spider-Man, right?
Yep.
Yeah, so it hasn't changed since then, and theaters are still shit. But, so nobody else was there. Nobody else showed up. It was us five, I think, in the theater, and Chili and I felt confident enough that we could at least whisper to each other, because there's no chance of anyone else hearing us.
So, let's see, so correlation to that, my wife and I, we took Friday, this past Friday, off. Because it was the day after my wife's birthday. And we decided to go to the movie. We went to like a 1 o'clock showing.
So we both went and saw it. Wait.
We saw 1 o'clock on a Friday.
Oh, okay.
Where people typically at work. So we had maybe eight to ten people in there, not including us. So, and we just went to the standard thing. We didn't do the 3D or anything.
Anyone yell out anything? Like, was anyone, like, fanboying over, like, oh my god, there's Medivh, and they just start whipping their dick out?
No one was fanboying
in there.
That was
me.
I did post pictures on Twitter. My wife was wearing an Alliance tank top, and I was wearing this shirt.
Nice.
So, that did happen.
I didn't wear anything. I actually didn't have my Sundering shirt with me. I probably should have worn it just in case somebody... I mean, the chance of anyone knowing, even our show, you know, but just, you know, recognizing Warglaives is rare. It'd have to be those three people. And we stayed because we were curious if there was going to be anything after the credits, so...
Was there? Because we didn't stay. So, overall, what did you think of it?
I'm not too, like, ultra... fine on the lore of everything and how it ended up, but I will say that they did a good, like, I felt they did a good job, but I also have a review from one of my friends who went and saw it while I was gone that doesn't know anything about Warcraft. I told him, go see it and tell me what you think if you feel like it, and he did. I mean, it's not a spoiler because it happens in lore, I guess. I don't know. Do I want to say spoiler? I guess I don't know. I'll wait, but I'm going to say something in a minute here. But, I don't know.
Today, Junior?
He was mad that Durotan died.
Well, of course he dies.
But he doesn't know that he dies.
Like, oh.
He didn't know anything about Warcraft, so he's like...
He's well, like, that's not really a spoiler.
I'm just saying, for... people are weird about movies and shit. So.
Durotan, that motherfucker dies.
Yeah, but
that's non-spoiler. Non-spoiler. He dies.
Well, I guess I shouldn't have danced around it like I did then.
I'm just going to point that out. He dies. I don't think that's a spoiler.
It took me a little while to figure out that the guy that played Medivh, the actor, was the same guy from 6 Feet Under and also the Thomas Jane Punisher. So, that was cool. He's a good actor.
I did not realize that.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know if you know who I'm talking about, but...
No, because I never was 6 Feet Under, but... Oh. Thomas Jane Punisher...
You know the guy that gets his piercings ripped out?
Yes!
That's him.
Oh, shit!
See, okay, so you're the only other person other than Dan that would have, like, gotten that reference, basically, my life, because nobody likes the Thomas Jane Punisher. I personally love it.
I like Thomas Jane as the Punisher.
All right.
I do like the new guy who they have playing Punisher on Daredevil. He is good.
Yeah. We all agree on that, too.
Okay. So overall, you liked it? You enjoyed it?
Yeah, they did really good. I felt the dwarves were represented very, very nicely. I felt like I was at home in Ironforge. oddly enough, it didn't give me a twinge to play the game like I thought it might. I thought maybe, like, but it did give me the... opportunity to make Chili watch the 5-hour Warcraft 3 lore thing. So we started it, but it was on the last night I was there, so it was just like, well, I could spend the next 5 hours explaining the lore along with watching it, or we could get more important things done. So we erred on the side of more important things, sir.
Bumping uglies.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I think you do. Alright, having relations.
Yeah.
Marital relations. Consummating the marriage.
My favorite thing is how the dog just knows that it's going to happen and just leaves. Just like,
oh, I can't watch this crap.
It's the only time I ever see her not be like, hey, what's going on? Why?
If I have to see that guy's hairy ass one more fucking time. I liked it. I thought some of the pacing was a little weird. I felt like they would, like, like some scenes like felt like they flowed really well, then all of a sudden just kind of like chopped up strangely.
Yes, I felt like they really did like those Star Wars style cuts without the transition. Like, you know how they would have like a slide go across? I feel like it was just that, but there's no transition. They're just like, boom, right into the next thing.
And like, it was weird because it would go from like a fast scene to like a really slow scene. And it was just like, I was just like, this. So that was like the one thing that I felt was always, it felt weird. It felt off watching the movie. Was just some of the pacing of the, how they cut some of the different scenes together. Overall, I liked it. I liked some of like the little like call-outs. I like seeing the Murloc.
Yeah, I pointed it out to Chili because I wasn't sure if she saw it or not.
I liked
it was right in the corner.
I liked the mage turning someone into a sheep.
That was also funny.
I did like the fact that the dwarves called the gun a boomstick. I did like that. That was good.
Yes, I also like when he hands them like right in the beginning when they're in Ironforge. He hands it to him, but then he's sitting there talking, and Lothar's just like, what is this thing? And he's just looking at it, like, into the barrel. I was just like, that's fantastic. I also thought he played a great, like, I liked how he played, like, well, I don't know much about Lothar, to be honest, but I liked the act, like, how he played him.
Well, so, you got to see Varian Wrynn as a young boy in the movie.
Yes.
You got to see, it's Anduin Lothar. That's his full name. So you know that Varian names his son after Lothar.
Yes.
So that's not spoiler related. This is just some history for you all. So just so you guys know, when you see Anduin in the game, he is named after Lothar from the movie and also from Warcraft 1. So there you go. So the question is, are they going to jump to, like, if they do a sequel, do they do Warcraft 2 next? Or do they lead up into, like, Warcraft 3?
I feel like it would be a race to get to Warcraft 3, wouldn't it?
I think so.
Because that's more characters that are, like, current with, like, what's in WoW, and
I feel like, I'm sorry, I know you love Illidan, but I think the Arthas storyline would make a fucking phenomenal movie.
Is that what Warcraft 2 is?
No, that's Warcraft 3.
Okay, no, I mean Illidan.
No. I think Illidan, Illidan happens, I think, in Warcraft 3.
Okay, I never played him, so I really don't
know. Well, Illidan happens, like, in the Well of Eternity, but that's, like, you don't really find out about him until, like, I think, like, Warcraft 3.
I mean, it's like standalone movie with the Well of Eternity, that whole, like, the three book series there would be fantastic. It would be a fantastic movie. Because visually, they can do that. Like, that just having that well in the set, like, just be the backdrop of that whole entire battle, it would be fantastic. It would be awesome.
Dude, if they did the Arthas thing, I would throw a huge goddamn party.
We know.
Watching him go, just watching him slaughter an entire, like, town.
From Warcraft 3. That's what you're excited about?
No, and then the transformation into the Lich King. Like, just ending the whole movie with him sitting on the throne and ice going over, like, that would just be bad fucking ass. So awesome. Watch him slowly delve into, basically madness. Be great. Be dark, but great.
Yeah.
So,
well, that would be the next one if they follow the Batman movie thing where the second one's really dark.
But see, the thing is, I don't know what they're going to do because for, like, the box office, like, apparently China has made $205 million. Yeah. The international total, worldwide total is $378.9 million, and apparently they need $500 million to break even. So they are still, like, $120 million away. Which, the international total apparently is $340 million, which means here in the U.S., it's only pulled in, like, $38 million. It has not done well here. It's not doing well.
And I guess nobody likes going to the movies anymore.
Well, I mean, it's,
I constantly hear it, man.
I mean, look, it's fucking expensive. So, like, to go see the Warcraft movie My wife and me, I mean, we paid like
This is going to be contrasting, too. I'm going to like the, like talking
so,
about it.
So we paid like $28. It was like $14 each. And then we wanted like popcorn and a drink. And next thing you know, we paid like another $16. So next thing you know, all of a sudden, we're up to $44 for a trip to the movies. Whereas if I waited this to come out on Blu-ray, it's $20 and a bag of popcorn, you know, out of the box that I get is like... Like a, let's just say a dollar. So all of a sudden, I've spent $21. It's less than half. Mm-hmm. So yeah, I mean, there. What's the value prop? I mean, I love going to the movies. I think it's fun. I like. It's one of my favorite things to do. But it's getting really expensive to do that versus like doing something else.
So much so that the fact that like, Chili and I don't ever go to the movies really. The last time her and I went to see a movie together was Trainwreck before Warcraft. That was last year when I was in Canada with her. So both times we didn't pay to go see the movie because she has one of those cards that she uses and she gets points on it. Like, I think it's a scene card. It's Canadian, so it might be different. But we went and saw Trainwreck for free. We went and saw this movie for free because she's just accumulated points over the years and she never goes unless I'm going. I think she went and saw Star Wars maybe. So, but like, we got that and like drinks and a free like candy, and we didn't have to pay anything. We upgraded the drinks though because I drink a lot, so I knew I was gonna be drilling a drink. So,
see, like at most of my theaters, they had those. Are you drilling another 4 ounce?
Yes.
A&W. Jesus Christ, Rush.
I told you that's all we have, and I. I'm just happy you left the air conditioner on. Otherwise, I'd already be going downstairs to get another drink.
I was going to say, most of our theaters, we have those like Coke machines where it's like the umpteen million buttons you can push.
Yeah.
And they have them out, like, they don't fill it up for you. You fill it up yourself, so you can get like a small drink and just go and refill it. They don't even care anymore. So you don't even have to upgrade drinks at most of the theaters near me anymore.
Yeah, but do you want to get up during the movie?
Well, that's why you, like, race and finish it before the movie starts, and then you go out and get a refill.
Okay. Just saying, man.
Or you sneak a giant water bottle into your, like, lady's purse, go into the theater, dump that in there, and then go fill it up again. It's kind of like what we do with our kids. You buy a large popcorn, it gets free refill. So what we do is we bring little brown bags, like lunch bags, and we fill that up with popcorn. We give one to each of the kids.
Are you a homeless person?
No, we just
brown bags all over the place.
Well, we give that to the kids, and then I go and fill out the popcorn thing again. What?
I'm gonna be on to you now.
Whatever.
Like, can I see if you have any brown paper bags? You're like, God damn it, I've been foiled.
They know what's going on. They know the score. They look at like me and the two kids and a wife. They're like, yeah, he's gonna fill that thing up.
Oh, should I save it for Foss?
Maybe.
Do I have another Foff? I guess I could have another Foff then. How many times did the person that checks the exit walk across the theater? Like, I don't know. I don't know if that's that specific. Like, he was walking across the thing, and since we were down near the bottom, he was like walking basically right in front of us. He checked the door like twice during the movie, and I've only seen it ever done once. And I'm just like, motherfucker, what? Like, and Chili was pissed off about it too. She was just like, why don't they? That's why they have like technology. Why does a person have to go check?
You look shady. That's what it was, right?
I did.
Yeah, you look shady. You're a shady motherfucker.
I don't think so.
Yeah, shady.
It's Canada, man. I don't think. I had a beard.
Well, here's what they're saying. They're like, there's an American impersonating Canadian here in the theater. We need to keep an eye on him. There's an American impersonating a Canadian here in the theater. He's got a beard. He has a beard. Believe he has maple syrup too. He's trying to pass himself off as Canadian. Someone please check on him.
After the movie, we went and walked in the mall. I forget. It's a store called like HMV or HVM or something like that. It has like music, books, and.
Oh my god! Jesus Christ! I just get the shit out of me.
That's really funny.
What is wrong with you? We're in the middle of a show here, and you come over and you tap me on the back with a water bottle?
I have to get that way.
Well, go!
I don't want to
go across the camera.
She's going across the camera, everybody!
I'm waving.
I'm waving. You're waving. That's kind of good. She's still standing there. She's still standing right there. Well, there she goes. There she goes.
Thanks.
There she goes. All right.
Sorry.
Jesus. I'm going to have to go back and see what that looks like on video later.
Yeah. See, that's why I set my computer up with me facing the door, so I can see if anyone tries to sneak in here. I'm ready to fucking hit them with my Green Lantern ring.
Sweet Jeebus.
Well, I guess you're good with, like, being able to withstand a scare. You didn't keel over, so...
Good God. Yelena says, there she goes. Alright, so other than that, it's a Warcraft movie. I've been playing Heroes of Storm, Overwatch. I've been getting my Garrison Gold before they take it away when they do the Legion pre-patch stuff. And honestly, a whole lot of Calm Before the Storm stuff is where I've been spending a lot of time. And our Kickstarter is over. It's fully funded. Now it's all the fulfillment bullshit is collecting surveys. What do people want? Trying to then work with third-party logistic companies to print stuff and all that other crap. So that is kind of what's going on for all that. What about you? So we kind of already established you went to Calgary. You went to go visit Chile.
Yes. That was fun.
Okay.
It was nice to get away for a little bit, you know. Go somewhere where my money's appreciated.
Don't they have Monopoly money as currency up there?
They really do. I love bringing it back with me and just showing people that have never seen it. They're like, what the fuck? Like,
so, so can I get Monopoly money out of my Monopoly game, bring it up there, and will they accept it?
Is that the way it works? I think the Canadian bills are bigger than the American bills. Oh. From what I can tell, my wallet, they stick out a little bit more.
So you have to get a new wallet or like a money clip.
I have to get a new wallet. No, I have a great wallet. It's a Destiny wallet. I don't have it up here with me, but... has Destiny stuff on it.
He's lost his wallet, folks.
I don't take it upstairs with me. It's... Where do you... Okay, you know what? Never mind. I'm not going to ask you where you keep
it. My wallet's right here.
Okay, well, see, that's the difference. I have it somewhere where I always go before I leave the house, you know?
I have it right here with me. You know why? Because I've caught my kids going in my wallet, taking my card.
See, you have that problem. Uh-huh. I'll let her know that you're pointing at her. I'll send her a clip of the video. Just be like, watch Sarah sell you down the river at like 15:49 or whatever the video's gonna be. So I flew out there and everybody was really confused by it because I drove to Toronto to fly to Calgary. And people were like, well, why didn't you fly out of Buffalo? And I'd be like, well, do you have an extra $500 laying around? Because Buffalo's fucking expensive as shit to fly out of.
It's expensive as shit to fly into, too.
Yes. So, why take a flight from Buffalo, which I guarantee will probably end up going to fucking Toronto anyways, because there's no direct flights. I almost guarantee it. It was really cheap. Like I think it was like less than $100 Canadian for the flight.
$100 Canadian? That's like less than $20 US.
It's not that bad. But the flight there, I did standby for the first time, which isn't any different than you just got to check in, which is checking in for your flight was always a thing that boggled my mind because I don't travel that often. But 24 hours before your flight, you check in. And I was like, what's the purpose? I already fucking bought a ticket. Well, when I'm flying standby, that I can see the purpose. So checking in actually made sense for me.
I want to throw out that Tully in the chat room said he paid $32 to go see Warcraft in IMAX 3D in Sweden.
Hmm.
That sounds really expensive.
Well, I mean, IMAX 3D is expensive in general anyways. So, are we going to have another scare?
Well, I don't know. I just saw them said, there she goes again. So I don't know if she walked by again.
That's fucking hilarious. Now we can freak you out. Like, up, she's writing shit on your chalkboard. Up, Seraph sucks.
All right.
Okay, so, flying. I drove to Toronto. Now, here's the tricky part for me. With the way my phone's set up, I really couldn't do anything outside of the States. So I had to go without any, like, GPS or anything to get to the Toronto airport once I crossed the border. Luckily, it's pretty easy. There's roads that pretty much go straight there. Don't have to do much. But it's still frustrating. And I ended up parking in the wrong parking lot. So it costs more, almost double, to park my car than it was to fly there. Just to park my car for the four to 4.5 days I was there.
Sweet Jeebus.
And it was only because I didn't want to miss my flight. I didn't know how, I still wasn't sure how the standby thing worked. So I was just like, oh shit, I gotta get there early, gotta make sure. There were no problems. And
what about like a bus to Toronto? Would that have been cheaper than parking? So
what would have been cheaper was me finding the Park and Fly parking lot, which was $10 a day. So it would have only cost $40 Canadian. Well, probably 50 because they charged me for the fifth day.
Which is only $5 American, everyone.
Of course. It would be $4 American according to your last logic.
Or a bottle of Aunt Jemima.
See, he just deflects because he knows I'm right. So I missed this. So I flew out there and I drove to. Goddamn.
What are you doing with your life?
I don't know, man. Listen.
Jeebus.
This Tuesday thing's throwing me off too, but I like it.
I got my bearings. Look, I even got scared out of my fucking mind.
There were only like one or two empty seats on the plane. And thank you. One of them was between me and the guy that was sitting next to me. So
was
he
a big
dude?
I
had the window seat, and I could actually like move this leg over just slightly and then put my foot out, which was so much better because on the way back, full plane, stuck in the window seat, and the seats were just a little bit too cozy for me. And the guy got mad at me for not being able to put his seat back because my knees were legit. Like pinned. He's like, "Hey, can you move your legs so I can do my seat thing?" And I'm like, "I can't move. I'm 6'5", dude." And he wasn't. I don't think he was too fond of the way I said 6'5". I don't know if that's something that's lost on somebody that wasn't from around here. But yeah,
I like getting the aisle seat because then I could kind of at least stick one leg out there, and then I could just tuck it in when they walk by with the cart.
So one thing I found out, I could change my seat, but it changes my priority on the standby, and I didn't want to do that. So,
that's fine.
Window seats are fine because I like to lean my head against the thing. I am a pretty good height for how most aircrafts have their. So,
Lemon says 6'5" was his trigger phrase. Ray, you triggered him.
Oh shit!
You triggered him.
Someone sent me a GIF that's just this lady with like her eyes are like wide open like this. And it's just the camera shaking, and it just says triggering intensifies. I have to find it, but it makes me laugh every fucking time I see it. The trip there was awesome. I should post I'll figure out how to post the video of the dog getting to see me for the first time in, like, since September. She was really confused. Like, she wasn't confused, but when we would come home from wherever we were for the day, the dog would sit there and freak out in the same way. This way, she came over and sat down immediately, like, very submissive, but she was shaking with excitement. You could tell her hind legs were like, oh my god, he's here.
And she pissed himself.
No, she did not piss herself. I was quite surprised, because I thought that might be the case. And, you know, when she comes back from places, sometimes, you know, you gotta let the dog out. So, it was nice to be there. I got to spend quality time with the animals, and my wife, too. No, that's the main purpose of the trip, to spend time with my squad, as we call it. Because it's the animal squad, man.
The Monster Squad?
No.
Oh, I like Monster Squad.
I heard that house was for sale.
I heard Wolfman's got nards.
What's a version? It's another line from that movie. Don't ask me why I know that, because that's like a movie that's kind of like in the same vein as The Goonies in my mind that I probably should have never seen, but I in this case I did see it.
All right.
I think that I played one. I didn't. Okay, so I played another character other than Zenyatta, but it wasn't on my account. It was on Shelby's, and I wanted to show her how to play Reinhardt, but I had never played him myself, so I played him, figured it out, and then showed her how to play him.
You like him?
I can see myself using him. I'm starting to get to the point where I am getting somewhat bored and almost like just being an asshole on purpose and going out way for overextending just because I'm bored.
You should not do that.
Well, you know. Also, are we going to talk about competitive play in Overwatch at all? in upcoming or?
I think we got some news item for.
And I'll wait to talk about that then.
I think we got new content. Yeah, we got we're gonna talk about that.
Okay, so cool. So I think I'm all set. Oh yeah, I got this hat.
Oh,
Deathstroke hat. It's sweet. It has a comic book thing of him on there. Oh, fantastic. And on the back it says.
Stroking out.
No, it says Deathstroke.
Oh, it should say stroking out. If it said stroking out, I'd consider buying it.
That'd be stupid.
Stroking out.
Alright. Move on to the next shit, then.
And now I'm going to hear some bullshit that happened somewhere.
Alright, so real quick, Calm Before the Storm, fully funded, like I said a few moments ago. Right now we're working on fulfillment. We don't actually get any of the money from Kickstarter yet. We actually have to wait like 14 days. So once we have the money and realize like how much like Kickstarter took and how many because some people's payment methods sometimes aren't good or they get rejected for whatever reason. So once we get the final number, then we can start figuring out, all right, what can we afford? And so a lot of that's going to be the interesting part. So right now I'm helping out, like, put together stuff for fulfillment, because Zia, who's not here, she's going to be handling a lot of the fulfillment of the prizes and everything. Since she's just, as she says, she's just sitting around with the baby, so she can handle fulfillment, so, sucker. She's going to be putting together everyone's reward packages and sending those out. So I'm trying to help her out with, like, consolidating all that information into one spot for her, which is a huge pain in the ass. But it's worth it. So there we go. Comment for the Storm. So hopefully we're going to get some more news out soon. Plus, I know a lot of people were saying that they just wanted to get some shirts or one of the add-ons. And like they back too late. We're working on a way for people to get shirts. Like the plushie or et cetera, whatnot. We're working on different methods for that. As I speak, we have someone working on that. To see what we could potentially do. So... stay tuned for that. And I think that's it for that. So let's talk about some bacon.
This is the king of bacon talking about bacon.
I have another foff.
All right. Hold on. Lemon says, Ray, is Deathstroke related in any way to Slade from that old Teen Titans TV show? Yeah,
they didn't use the name Deathstroke because it was a show for younger kids, so they just call him Slade, which kind of hurts his notoriety because a lot of people know who Slade is from Teen Titans. But yeah, Slade Wilson, who was ripped off by Deadpool, like Deadpool totally like.
You mean Wade Wilson?
Yes, Wade Wilson.
Rhymes with Slade Wilson.
Yeah, it's interesting. OG.
Stroking out.
Shut up.
Might be a show title.
No! I refuse to have that be the show title. It ain't happening.
Alright, so there was a... it's a British store that suggested adding peanut butter to a bacon sandwich. And they called it a bacon buddy. And apparently there were people who were very pissed off about this.
Okay.
I don't know what this tastes like, but I'd be willing to try it. Because chocolate and bacon seem to go well together. I've had ice cream and bacon, and that seemed to have gone all right. I even had a maple bacon donut recently, and that was delicious. I don't know if this is to the point where you should be, like, threatening to beat your children if they ate it, like some people did. But I'd be willing to try it. What do you think?
Probably not.
All right, well, fuck you then. You know, I always tell my kids they gotta try new things, and you're like, no, fuck that, I'm not trying anything new.
I just said it because it's bacon news. I didn't say I wouldn't try new things. Fucking Chili and I made an amazing, like, restaurant style Chinese, like, chicken fried rice. It's fucking fantastic. Like, you follow the YouTube video this guy did? It was amazing.
Alright.
So, I tried something new.
Alright, well, Lemon says, how about that bacon bourbon? The bacon bourbon was terrible. But I tried it, at least. I tried it. And it was terrible. Absolutely god-awful. And I'm pretty sure that's the reason why I threw up at the British Stadium. But that's a whole other story.
Mm-hmm.
Whole other story. But yeah, I'd be willing to try it. I don't think this deserves the outrage it got, personally. That's my thoughts. Final words of wisdom on peanut butter and bacon sandwiches.
Outrage is dumb.
Just stroking out. It's going to be a thing, Ray. All right. I want to bring this up real quick. An appeals court upheld net neutrality. So, telecoms wanted to, like, throw this out saying it was, like, unconstitutional, all that bullshit. But they lost. They lost. Net neutrality won. Fuck you, Comcast. Fuck you. For those of you who don't know what net neutrality says, it means that all traffic is equal. It means that Comcast or AT&T or Verizon, they can't slow down one if they accept payment from another. So it's just like, they say, hey, Netflix, if you want your stuff to get to our customers fast, you have to pay us a premium, which they kind of already do, which is a whole other story. Versus, like, if Ray and I decided to make a video streaming service and we couldn't pay the exorbitant, like, extortion fees that Comcast and AT&T wanted to pay, our service would run really fucking slow, if not at all, to end consumers. So, boom!
Net neutrality. We do plan on making a streaming service. I mean,
net neutrality wins. Fuck you, Comcast. Fuck you. Alright. That's all I got there. That was good. Alright. So, E3 also happened. That was a big thing. And apparently, one of the stories was Microsoft could be adding some older titles to Steam. Huh. Like, Age of Empires, Ori and the Blind Forest could make their ways.
Interesting.
But apparently first-party games we shouldn't expect, like Halo and probably Gears of War we won't see.
Of course not.
Anytime soon, but... What do you think about that? Does it really matter?
If they made the original Shadowrun from Sega Genesis... Somehow, because I know Microsoft, like, had a remake of Shadowrun. Like, it was on, like, games for Microsoft, like, when they first started doing that. Or games for Windows, whatever it's called.
Well, they couldn't get rid of that. They're doing a new thing where, like, all, like, these new games that are coming out will also be able to be played on Windows 10. So if you buy it on an Xbox Live, by, like, digital version, you'll also be able to play it on Windows 10.
Huh. Well, I don't plan on playing any of the games you mentioned.
So, like, I know that, like, I think it's, like, the new Gears of War game that's coming out. Like, if you buy it digitally on Xbox Live, you will also be able to play it on your Windows PC as well.
I feel like that's fair. I'm not gonna freak out about it because, I mean, I'll probably end up playing it on the computer instead of the console anyways.
So there you go. I'm not, like, this isn't a make or break thing for me. If they don't offer Microsoft games on Steam, like, it's no skin off my nose, really.
I feel the same way.
I mean, still play Civilization. Which, yeah. By the way, I re-downloaded Civilization 5.
Should we play that sometime?
We should. We should. We should do that. I got an itch to play Civilization 5.
That's not a good itch, by the way. That's like a, here's 10 hours straight down the drain.
You're like, oh, well, I'll just build a city. Just one more turn. Next thing you know, it's...
Gandhi started talking shit. I have to take him out.
Dude, when Gandhi talks shit, you gotta put him down.
He will nuke you.
You can't let that shit fly. You can't be stroking out when Gandhi is threatening nukes. No nukes. No nukes.
He acts all nice, but...
Mm-mm. Lemon said that he would totally dick around with people in a Civ game. I've never played Civilization 5 multiplayer. I want to do that. I want to just, like, kick back, relax, talk some shit with people, and play some Civ 5. That would be awesome.
All right, Sarah, if I got a quick question.
Okay.
I feel like this is going to be our sports segment, since I don't think it's in the show notes. I missed this past week I wanted to move this show to Tuesday because I had to work late, but also Game 7 was on. And I'm only, you know, 3 hours away from Cleveland, so it's always been a secondary rooting place, but, you know, we don't, Buffalo doesn't have an NBA team, so I feel like, you know, the Cavaliers winning is a good, it's a good thing for this area. But I also want to know, how can the show title incorporate me blocking you shooting a basketball? Because that's what the show image is going to be. Because LeBron had an epic block at the end of the game to basically win it.
Stroking out?
I don't know. How are we going to... How? There's no stroke involved. I can see...
Nice stroke? A nice stroke of the shot? I'm stroking? Boom! See, look at that. Worked it. Worked it in. Right. Struck it out. Struck it out. Stroking. Boom!
You just throw out a bunch of things. Shh. And then
the crowd grows wild. Next. Look at that stroke that you put on that ball. Boom. See? Works. Alright. Next up is PlayStation branded wet wipes. I don't know if anyone else knows this, but at like the PlayStation like booth at E3, they had PlayStation branded wet wipes.
Okay.
Why is this a thing? Why did this need to be a thing? This angered, like, I was tempted to use this as a FOF, but then I had to bring this up. Because I actually saw the stream, and then I saw an article here on The Verge. This is, like, wet wipes don't need to be branded by a console. Like, they're just like basic wipes. They're wet. You use them to wipe your face,
Did
your hands.
Did you ever think you were going to say that sentence?
No!
Wipes shouldn't be branded by a console.
No! How is... Why am I saying this? This should not be something I talk about.
Or should it be?
I don't fucking know. I don't know what PlayStation's thinking. This is stupid. Don't break... They could have just been like Huggies wet wipes. It doesn't matter. Just like... Don't leave them out. This angers me. PlayStation wet wipes. Just use a generic brand. All right, the Ray.
Yeah.
This next one is for you.
Oh yeah.
It's about virtual reality. Virtual reality. You can now be a bird. On PlayStation okay. VR.
Why is this only for me?
You can soar like an eagle. Because I would never want to VR as a bird.
Really?
Yeah.
I mean, have you VR'd with this new technology they have?
I don't find any of this interesting. Like, if you want to fly as a bird, you can do it on PlayStation VR, right?
It sounds fun. I don't see why you're, like, saying it doesn't sound fun.
Well, they also show, like, there's, like, this whole, like table where you put your hands like on this like flapping thing, and then it had like a fan in front of you blowing wind in your face too.
That sounds more dangerous.
Yeah, well, so yeah, so you could do all that and actually be a bird in virtual reality. Are you excited to fulfill your bird RP dreams?
Well, since it's PlayStation VR, that's never happening unless some one of my friends has it. But I realized Google Cardboard is cheap, and I have a, like, you know, Samsung. Shouldn't that like be a thing?
Oh, I got Google Cardboard.
Have you used it?
Yeah, I used it on the Warcraft Legendary thing. I don't know if you Legendary okay. where it basically you're sitting on a griffin and you're flying over Stormwind.
Huh. But it's cheap, right? Like that little thing you just got, you just showed. Like, it's not much.
I got that off of Amazon for, like, $20. I think, like, the most expensive part about it is because, like, you have to get these, like, special, like, lenses in there. It's, like, special, like, I can't remember if it's convex or concave lenses that make it work right.
Yeah, I just figured, like, it's a cheap way to have something kind of cool. So I might rock it.
So, yeah, so I picked it up for $20.
I'll be a bird someday, sir. You wait.
Lemon says size at bird RP shenanigans. Matthew says I wake up at 8 and I hear birds and I'm like, shut the fuck up, birds. I'm trying to sleep in.
I have there's just nothing but birds around here. It's great.
Now here's something that is for us, Ray.
Oh, really?
We can design our own Xbox controllers. It's $80.
Oh, yeah. I saw your tweet. You had one of your kids do it, right?
Yeah, I had both my kids do it.
Ah.
And, yeah.
So that's how much I can read.
But, yeah, but you could design your own controllers. So, interesting. Oh, my goodness. I'm clicking buttons here. But, yeah, you could design your own controller.
Now, would you want one that, like, kind of matched your, I'm going to say, like, your chair, maybe your headphones, if you had the same kind of, like, black and white headphones?
Like, I think...
black and white combination?
I think, like, I had, like, a white body with black buttons on top. I did the back as black, I think. And then, or maybe, wait, no, maybe I'd, no, I did the buttons, I think, as dark red. I think I did. And then, I'm trying to do, like, D-pad as red, and I think the thumbsticks as red. And I did the buttons as black and white. Yeah, so basically, I made, like, a bacon controller. It's red and white. And you could actually engrave a name for an extra $10, and I'm thinking about putting Bacon King on there. It's my controller. That's what I'm thinking about doing.
I don't agree with that last part.
Huh?
So I don't agree with that last part.
The Bacon King?
Yeah.
Well, tough. Bacon King says he wants a controller. You could also do like a red, white, and blue. You could do like a Captain America one. And you could do all sorts of crazy shit. My biggest problem is, like, I got these, like, Energizer rechargeable batteries that are black. So I feel like the back of the controller has to be black.
You would hate to see mine. Mine would be as ridiculously colorful as my shoes are. They're colorful, by the way.
I still
have them with me.
Well, either way. So, yes, you can play around with that. I'm actually thinking about making my daughter the one that she designed as a present for starting kindergarten. Because I want to support her gaming and geeky habits.
That's pretty neat.
So there you go. Would you do this? I know it's a little expensive. If you had the money...
The money, yeah, of course. I just don't. It's hard to think of that right now.
I would actually like to see what your design is, if you made one.
Okay.
And you can make one and take a You don't have to do it right now, but I'd definitely say, you should...
Now you're making me want to, though.
But we're about to talk about Overwatch.
More Zenyatta talk.
Alright, so Overwatch, new content being made. So first up on the PTR is competitive mode with maps. Well, let's just talk about competitive mode. Competitive mode is up. You've played around with it on the PTR.
Yeah, I downloaded the PTR a little bit before the show and played one game in the competitive mode. And I got yelled at immediately for picking Zenyatta. And this is before the team even shaped up. I think one other person picked Soldier 76.
Oh my goodness. My dog, ladies and gentlemen.
Hey, sometimes it happens.
Jesus H. Christ. This is what I'm dealing with.
Huh.
I'm sure it's like my wife going downstairs, and he's like, what's that? What's going on? What's going on? What's happening?
Something's happening.
I'm still right here.
Oh. Actually, my wife was still down here.
Yeah, you didn't know that?
No, but she just walked past. She went after the dog. Anyway.
What was I talking about?
I don't know.
Yeah, exactly.
That dog screwed everything up.
Seriously.
God damn.
So I was on the PTR. I got yelled at for picking Zenyatta. And that person immediately picked a Mercy, so I can see why they wanted me not to be Zenyatta. But I obviously didn't listen to him. Didn't say anything. Got yelled at for, quote-unquote, overextending, but everybody behind me got killed. So it looked like I was just out there by myself. I had people with me, I swear. I got yelled at for that. And I was just like, man, this is kind of shitty, getting yelled at by these people. I really didn't like it. But, yep, she went by again.
That happened.
And we lost horribly. And I was just like, yep, I'm done for now. So it wasn't good. But I just placement matches. I want to see what me switching at that point to any other character wouldn't be good. I would automatically be worse regardless of our team chemistry. Now, yes, I know. I should try other people, and I will eventually. But
in competitive mode, you can get like gold weapons as rewards.
That's also exciting. Like, now, are my balls going to be gold? Because that's my
body. Actually, yes, they would have gold balls. You would have gold balls.
Sweet.
And Bastion would have like a giant golden rod sticking out from him, which is just ridiculous.
Yeah, I would. I will place myself, but I can't see myself doing too much competitive stuff. I'm not. Not really that competitive.
Just do a whole bunch of quick play.
Yeah, I quick play. I go in there. I play Zenyatta until I don't feel like doing it anymore. Go and do something else.
They also said that by the end of the year, they're going to have new maps and new characters. Other than that one character that we kind of talked about, like Pharaoh's mother, I think we talked about her briefly, how they kind of mentioned her, like a kind of like a sniper, but sniper support. That'd be interesting, but I'm not quite sure what they could add that would be really push the envelope.
Your dog's just drinking over there.
Yeah.
I can hear it. It just made me laugh. Damn it.
You're real professional.
Everything happening behind you is distracting me, too.
Glad we're doing a show on a Tuesday.
Hey, it's okay. It's more exciting on your end, apparently. You got more stuff going on Tuesdays.
I do apparently have a lot of stuff going on behind me.
Apparently on Sundays, it's like, nope.
Sundays, nothing happens. Tuesdays, everything happens. But no, so new maps. How many new maps do you think they should come out with by the end of the year?
Personally, I don't care because that kind of stuff doesn't bother me. I like being very good at the limited maps we have right now. I don't like learning new maps. I guess I am competitive then.
I would like a really cool like. I would like to see like an open field. Like Halo had some like really cool like open fields. Like what was that? The Gulch. They had the Gulch map.
Oh, in Halo.
Yeah, Blood Gulch. I think that would be kind of cool. Like you have like kind of like these like areas, the opposite ends.
That would be. I mean, are they ever gonna come out with just a straight up deathmatch, like where there's no objective? Because I feel like that. What are we, capture the flag for that map? If we were going straight up Halo, that's what that map was a capture the flag map.
I mean, you could probably do.
If they did that, I would make a red versus blue thing with nothing but Zenyattas.
They could probably do it like where you have to like hold like multiple points on the map. Oh, and so the longer you hold those multiple points, the more points you earn.
Yeah, I can see that. Having like the two bases be like I'm just looking at Blood Gulch as like an actual blueprint for a map. And have the two bases be like where you start off, basically like your A and C, and then have B be in the middle of the map.
Yeah, and then like have like 3 points that like if you hold two of them, like you win. If you only hold one, you don't. So there's like some incentive for you to go after like the third one or something.
They do it in Destiny with I think it's called control or zone control or something like that.
So that could be pretty cool if they do something like that. But yeah, I think like an open map like where there's like. I wouldn't say where there's no places to hide or cover, but, like, it's a little bit more sparse. It could be interesting. More of like a field instead of, like, in a city, I think would be cool. So, I mean, our chat room's talking about, like, weather and, like, temperature and snow and... We're not even interesting to the chat room
anymore. We've lost the whole chat room. You know, I don't like Change Hasu, you are right. I will say that the weather here has been ridiculously hot. That's why I'm leaving my air conditioner on for the show, because it would be unbearable otherwise. I was like, yesterday it was so hot that I was sweating with the air conditioner on. It's fucking hot.
I would like... Trying to think. Like, I feel like I would like another assassin character. But, like, I don't know what kind.
Are you talking about a stealth character? Because that is a deal breaker for some people for that game. That if there is ever a actual stealth character.
No, that's not like. I don't like playing stealth games, really. Like, I've tried. What's that game with the.
Hitman?
Huh?
Hitman?
No, not Hitman. It's the other one where, like.
Assassin's Creed?
No, god damn it. It's the one where he has, like, the helmet and he's, like. God damn, there's like 50 million of those games.
Splinter Cell.
Yes, Splinter Cell. I was terrible at it because like half the game was me just sitting around waiting for someone to pass. I was like, I can't do this. I can't play this. It's fucking ridiculous. So, but no, I think like another assassin character. I think like one more support character, and I'd say one or two more maps would be good.
Yeah, I whatever they do, you know.
I really think, though, that they're going to need to add some a little bit more flavor to it because I feel like the PvP can get stale after a while. Like they're going to have to do something. It can't just be this PvP game and that's it. They really need to expand on, I think, this Overwatch universe more and soon. I think they can make a mobile game. They should make Overwatch mobile games.
Are you just trying to piss me off?
Yeah, actually I am. I really am.
I mean, I won't play it. I will say that. Fucking mobile gaming. Get out of here. Oh, so I want a mobile game, but I'm in a different country. I can't use any cellular minutes or any data or whatever. And my flight that happens to not have Wi-Fi. Oh, well, guess what? Even if you did have a game on your phone, you wouldn't be able to play it because everything requires a fucking connection anymore. And Blizzard would be no different. I don't like... Okay, so I'm very against having my cellular connection be on all the time. Because I like to use my like iPhone 4S to listen to podcasts and stuff, and it's getting harder and harder to do that. It's annoying.
All right. Well, speaking of getting pissed off, there was an alleged hacker called out by the pros. So there was this girl, 17-year-old girl, who apparently was so good with Zarya, who is the big Russian tank character. That two members of an opposing team said she was hacking. Well, the two pros said that they would quit esports if this girl could prove them wrong. Well, she did. So they quit. She really was that good.
Oh, man, I wish I could be that good with Zenyatta. Make somebody quit.
Yeah, this girl was that good with Zarya that she made someone quit. So there you go. And a 17-year-old girl at that. 17-year-old Korean gamer. Boom. She proved that she was not a cheater.
Hmm.
So there you go. Two people quit esports because they were like, well, hang it up. We were idiots.
Well, at least they're honoring their word.
I guess. Well, isn't it like if you don't go with your word, like, you get, like, sliced by a samurai sword or something over there?
Maybe when there were samurai still.
Okay. So anyway, so that's the thing. So it was quit
samurai are done.
So maybe it was either quit esports or get stabbed with a samurai sword. No?
I wonder if all they right. can still play the game, though. they have to really quit.
Well, they quit esports. It doesn't mean that they quit playing the game, but... I mean, what are you going to do?
How funny would it be if they ran into her again? They're like, God damn it. I know she's cheating.
Well, I guess then they would have a FOF, wouldn't they?
Oh.
And I believe that is a good segue into our FOFs.
Fuck you, fuck you, fuck you, you're cool. Fuck you, fuck you.
Fuck you.
Fuck you.
Fuck you.
Fuck you.
Fuck you.
Fuck you. Fuck you, Saddam Hussein of Iraq.
Alright, Ray. You said that you were going to have another FOF. What is it?
We're leaving to take me to the airport. A legit biker gang was turning at a four-way stop. Now, I don't know bike laws. Okay? Not too familiar with them. I'm pretty sure we don't have to wait over 5 minutes for an entire bike gang to all turn left. Pretty sure we shouldn't have to do that. I'm pretty sure also that none of us were going to try and tell them that they couldn't do it. But faff to them for having that kind of fear over us, because goddamn, I was really mad, and I was also upset because they were also going the same way we were. So if they weren't going fast, we might have been late. That would also have sucked. So faff to that biker gang, but I don't know who they are. And if I did, I wouldn't call them out by name, because they scare me.
Okay.
They do. I'm sorry. I know they're not like these. I know there's also people that just ride bikes and aren't in like those gangs, but I'm telling you, man, I've heard things. It's scary. What about you?
Let's see. So I got a. So first off, fall off to fuckers who schedule meetings at work in our downtown office at 5 p.m. Look, there's fucking traffic in Atlanta. Maybe you don't have shit to do when you get home. Maybe you don't care about getting home. But the rest of us give a shit about our lives. So fuck you. All right? Huh?
We do?
Well, I do.
Oh.
But apparently these people don't. They don't want to go home. They're a bunch of dicks. So, I fucking hate that. I hate like getting email like, oh, well, we really need you to attend. I'm like, you know what? You're going to have to add a dial-in call for that, because I'm not going to be there. I'll be on the road. That's, like, fuck you. And then also, fall off to... There was this one fucker in the comments section of MMO Champion who said going to parties like Calm for the Storm at BlizzCon is stupid and a waste of time. Yeah, go sit in your hotel room and diddle yourself. You know, there are tons of fucking parties at BlizzCon. In fact, I would say that the parties are a ton better than BlizzCon itself. That's where you hang out with all the people.
From somebody that didn't go to BlizzCon yet, technically. I've been in the area, but I've never gone to the actual convention. I don't have that kind of money. It's still fun.
I mean, though, I will say props to the people on MMO Champion who basically, like jumped all over this guy and said, but, like, the parties are fun. Parties are where it's at. This guy was a fucking douche canoe, if I ever saw
one. Was it the guy that punched me in the face at the first one?
No, I don't think so. The guy was Australian, though.
I forgot who it was, but somebody started following Chili, and she just goes, he follows a bunch of WoW people. I wonder if it's the guy that punched you in the face. I'm just like, if it is, block him. I don't want to deal with it.
He also pinched Ben from Azeroth Roundtable's nipples. Same guy.
He's just one of those guys that has to do stuff like that. I don't know.
Australians. I love all Australians. I'm not saying it's all Australians, but I'm just saying he was Australian, and Australia was a prison colony. It was. These are just facts.
I know. I have a video I had to show you after this because that makes me really laugh. No, seriously. It is a prison colony.
Let's see. And then also I want to say props to my wife and kids for getting me some awesome shirts for Father's Day. That was amazing. And I'm going to say faff to my wife for scaring the shit out of me on the show earlier.
Oh, I'm going to say props to Sarah's wife for scaring it, because that was really funny.
Alright, let's see. Matthew sent in an email and said props to finally beating Plantera in Terraria. Ever since October, I have been stuck on this fight. At one point, it wasn't fun to play. And props to playing LAN with my friend. He also adds, I'm going to add this. Props to the Terraria wiki, because without it, I'd be completely fucking lost. Damn you, Lemon Turtle. There's certain things you should not quote.
All right.
Do you want to do Lemon?
I'm trying to. Fall off to myself for missing the last two streams due to laziness. And props to myself for setting up a. What in my backyard? BFT?
Big fucking tent.
Gotcha. And then he says props to whoever's making emojis for making a bacon emoji. I didn't know there was one.
There isn't a bacon emoji, but apparently there's supposed to be one soon. I need a bacon emoji in my life. Once that happens, like, shit's getting real. you got my number, shit's going down. I'll be using emojis on Twitter. It's going down. It's happening.
I don't have Civilization installed now, just so you know.
Yeah, you're gonna have to do it.
I just was looking to see if we could do it after the show, or just at least do something stupid really quick, but no, it's not possible for me. It would probably take too long to download.
All right. I think that is it. So now, haikus? Haikus.
Or is it a Serku?
No, it's going to be a haiku. Sure. Serku is only if I use the term red cup in it. I don't have that term. I'm in my haiku.
Big titties and ass. She wants to be inside you. Haikus from Zia.
Do I have to stall?
For a moment, I need one more line.
Do I have to block the stroke? Maybe that's what we should call it. Blocking the stroke. Because I know it's going to have stroke in
it. All right.
I can't even see you typing it, but I feel like it's going to have stroke in it.
All right, here we go.
I knew it. I saw it. Spoiler.
Here's my haiku. Ready? Ray is stroking out. Biker gangs run Canada.
That's also not true.
Monopoly cash.
You're an asshole.
All right, so who's still hanging out with us?
Update that list. Have we added? Nope,
no.
We've lost. All right, so.
People are like, fuck this shit. I can't deal with this.
We got Rafist. We got the Sundering. We got Curse Atbot. Lemon Turtle, Matthew Ripped, Serafina, and Tola Bardeen.
Tully,
whatever. Also, I'm just going to act like Twinblade Dan's in there. I feel like he's always in there. That's upsetting.
All right. Ray?
What are we calling this episode?
Stroking out.
God damn it.
All right, Ray, where can people find you?
Only because I found a actual Deathstroke kind of font. I am not. I'll go with it. It's Rayfist on Twitter. That's RAYFYST.
All right, you can find me on Twitter at Seraphist, Xbox Live, Amish Mafia, 2 words. PlayStation Network, Seraphist Prime, 1 word. Steam, I am Seraphist. Zia is on Twitter at ITSXIA. It's Zia. Our producer, Mr. Hasu, is on Twitter at MR_HASU. Our show you can find at thesundering.net. Our Twitter is at thesundering. Facebook.com/thesundering. Our YouTube channel, where we put all of our videos, gameplays, and stuff, is youtube.com/thesunderingpodcast. Our Steam group is thesundering, 2 words. Our Sundering Discord channel, which, by the way, I need to get an updated link. It should be static now because I made it so it never expires.
Nice. So
I need to get that. Let's see. Our phone number, 323-SUNDER-0 or 323-786-3370. Let's see. Let me grab that link, and I'm going to put that in here. Alright, so that is the new updated link, so we need to put that into our show notes. Right? Our email is thesunderingpodcast@gmail.com. Let's see. And we are a member of D20 Catalyst, part of the D20 Crit Network. Our intro is courtesy of Boxing Fox. It saddens me that they are no longer a band, but we thank them for their music anyway. Also, we want to thank everyone who submitted a follow-up from our chat room and participated in their own way. So fuck downloads, advice to your home, your ears, your head. We just want to be inside you. Next time, we podcast from a Canadian biker bar. That's what we're doing.
Shit, I could have made a fucking better episode.
You're still here? It's over. Go home. Go.
I rolled a 20.